Humans aren't the only ones that tell fibs. Back in the 1970s, Coco, the gorilla who had been trained in sign language, blamed her pet kitten for ripping the sink out of the wall in her room. Do you really think it was the kitten that ripped the sink out of the wall? We're talking about deceit today. Welcome to Truth Talk with Ed Skipper, published 3 times a week. Peter has written that we've been born again of imperishable seed, and that's one reason why we ought to love deeply from the heart. And he writes in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 1, therefore, rid yourself of all malice and all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and slander of every kind. Rid yourself of all deceit. Who are we imitating when we deceive people? Whom Jesus called the father of lies, the devil, Satan. Now, Hitler, certainly not surprisingly, rose to power largely because of the lies that he told on the international scale. For example, in discussing appeasement and reapportionment in Czechoslovakia with Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain, he said, there's no need for war, just give me what I want. Well, Chamberlain trusted him, and this is what jump-started World War II. So who do we imitate when we tell the truth? God or Jesus Christ. And we are being renewed in the image of our Creator. So that is what we ought to want to be doing. It is Jesus, it is God, actually, who Titus 1:2 says, cannot tell lies. So Hitler, going back to that, it's interesting to me that you might ask, why did these everyday soldiers carry out what he asked them to do? Well, part of the reason was that he lied to them. For example, he took prisoners who were Polish and riddled them with bullets after putting soldiers' uniforms on them, and then staged a scene to make it look like Poland had invaded Germany, and Germany's invasion of Poland was a response to that, which was a lie. And that's one of the reasons why probably the soldiers did what they were willing to do. Now, personally, when I think of deceiving, when I deceive people, what's the reason? For me, it usually means I don't want to look bad, or I want to look good. And I've also thought of this. Deceiving is tricking somebody. So we can technically say something that's not a lie, but our intent is still to deceive. You might ask me to go to a certain social event, and I may tell you, oh, I've got such and such going on that day. Well, it may be that my event is hours before the event that you're inviting me to, and so my intent is to deceive you into thinking that I have a conflict when I don't have a conflict, even though technically I did not tell a lie. We want to get rid of all deceit, because that's what Peter writes under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Now, make sure that if you're watching on YouTube that you subscribe and hit that bell. If you're watching on Facebook, like or share or comment. If you're listening to the podcast, give Truth Talk a rating. And until next time, may you have a heightened awareness of when you are deceiving people, and may you have a greater commitment not to deceive.